Fighters Guild recruiting. Sweet. All right. Cool. I might as well just deactivate that crest, can I? Can I just deactivate him? Yeah, take that off. Alright. I mean, as cheesy as it is, it really does help me do stuff. Things like the poster, I mean, I don't know where they want it.
What is it?
What is it?
It's a Fighters Guild poster.
Hmm?
Ed Warren?
Can I help you?
Have I talked to him? This is great. I don't remember him. Are you Thalmor?
Do these rags look like Thalmor robes to you?
Yeah, now I remember him.
Seems like everyone looks at an Altmer and sees Thalmor. It's attitudes like this that brought this refugee camp into being. Think on that.
Yep, I'm thinking while I'm running over here. Cool. Satisfying.
Yes, traveler? What do you need?
I need to place another poster. Where else should we put them?
Got a lot of copies here. Interested?
Copies of what?
Hello.
What papers do you have for sale?
Looking for the news.
You're a newspaper boy. Okay, cool. Two Black Horse Couriers, a Kalovian Chronicle. These I've seen then. Yes, I remember reading these. So I'll get this one and this one. Kalovian Chronicle, Black Horse Courier.
Bye.
You're welcome. I guess they'd be here, actually. No, those are scrolls. Black Horse Courier. Nern Theater to close. The Imperial Government has released a statement finally confirming the rumors swirling about the Nern Theater. It has officially lost its sponsorship and will be permanently closing its doors sometime in the near future. The statement has been printed below in full. In the earlier days of our Grand Emperor's reign, when civilized life flourished in a great renaissance, the Nern Theater and other large works of art and culture were viable as publicly funded institutions. Unfortunately, due to a severe lack of public funds, the Empire has made, with a characteristically heavy heart, the decision to close the theater until further notice. Inescapable bureaucratic mismanagement and financial waste associated with the theater's recent ventures cannot be supported or subsidized by imperial taxes. In these trying times, reconstruction, the production of food, and the reparation of relations with our new partners in the Aldmeri Dominion must take precedence over all else. Art cannot not protect your children, which means it can. See, it's a little hidden message in there. Or grow our crops. Imperial cultural funding will return in due time, but we must recognize that art cannot flourish without the support of a stable society upon which it can be created and appreciated. However, the White Gold Tower does recognize the important cultural contributions of the theater and will be graciously sponsoring a limited set of farewell productions showcasing some of the greatest achievements and acts of heroism in our empire. The opening production will be a reenactment of the Siege of Bruma, starring the talents of Varian Cialis as Martin Septim, Quintus Laureus as the Savior of Bruma, and Tyrannus Maximus as the noble Captain Mead, who valiantly protected the citizens from the Daedric onslaught before the arrival of the hero. Standing, sitting, and box seat tickets are available now from our approved vendor, The Velvet Curtain. This is a sad day for the arts. This reporter would encourage all those who can attend the final performances to do so. The playwright in residence, the esteemed Cassius Curio. I thought it was Cassius Curio. Bentior, has already promised to put on a spectacle worthy of the gods themselves to bid the theater farewell. Scipio Florian, cultural correspondent for the Black Horse Courier. The Black Horse Courier is Cyrodiil's premier newspaper, providing objective commentary on current events in Cyrodiil and beyond. You need to look no further than the Black Horse Courier for all your news needs. I don't know why you have an ad in the back of it. We've already bought it. So what's the other one? Kalovian Chronicle. Fighters Guild expanding. According to the head of the Coral Branch of the Fighters... I'm not sure if it's Churl... Coral Branch? Of the Fighters Guild. Philippa Petros, the Imperial Institution, has finally stretched its wings and begun the construction of its first countryside guild halls. When asked why the guild was now looking to expand its horizons, Petros quoted, "The Fighters Guild has always strived to provide the best service to its clients, no matter the difficulty, of the endeavor. Alas, our presence in the countryside has recently dwindled, and those who need our help the most go unheard. Starting today, the Fighters Guild will hear their calls and we will answer. The guild is expected to face very few problems in its new endeavor, as expenses for the project are subsidized by the Empire using funds previously allocated to new priories and woodsmen lodges, and should prove to be far more beneficial than either of the above. For more information, see Philippa Petros on the subject in the Churl Fighters Guild Hall just next to the city's northern gate. Norbert Thrass, researcher for the Kalovian Chronicle. Greetings, fair citizen. Is your armor feeling the wear of time? Has your sword dulled to the point where cutting hedges is impossible? Never mind Wolfhide. We here at the Kalovian Chronicle recommend you go see Varner Grogask, and his wife Malog at their family-owned store, the Oaken Armory in Churl. This wonderful smithy is located directly across from the south gate on the right side of the street. Remember, don't wait. A dull blade means a dead you. I like that. Thanks, kid. Let's see if I can bring up a map if it shows me. Now I'm getting an actual map of the location. It wasn't working before. Yellow view in. Here's the last thing. Okay, so I am here. So I need to head left and... Well, no, right and forward. From where I'm...
Looking for the news!
I just got it. Courier?
Nope. Sorry. Nothing.
Okay. I need to talk to you, but first...
Please, madam. Just one step in.
First, we must speak.
Ah, good to see you.
I've been told you're interested in getting Renod to shut up.
I am. I try to be fairly humble. But sitting here day after day, not being able to hear myself think for the racket he's causing, well, it dries my scales.
Scales?
Why do you ask?
Words missing.
Are you interested in helping? There certainly isn't much a lowly Argonian beggar could do.
Oh, I'm not gonna kill him. He's a beggar. Why would they pay? I'll just talk to him.
Thank you very much. I am a beggar. I can't even afford a roof over my head, and I can barely afford to eat. However, if you were to deal with Renod, I can arrange for you to be paid.
The Screeching Songman. Alright.
It is good to see a familiar face around here, friend. What can I do for you?
Yeah, I have another coin.
Bless you, madam. Bless you. Farewell.
Thank you. So now I have another quest. The Screeching Songman. The citizens of Bruma have grown tired of a bard called Renod Eventoned, whose poor quality performances are becoming a great irritant. Round Tay, an Argonian beggar, said he would try to reward me if I got him to shut up, but warned me that he would inform the authorities if I killed the Screeching Songman. He did? Okay, well, I'm not gonna kill him. Alright, so I need to, yeah, do a few more things. I need to get payment, just to the right. I'll finish that off. Additional. You growl at me. Yeah, heading to the left now. I passed it. All this milk thistle keeps distracting me. Icewind trainers. It is up there. They won't get arrested for going in here. I thought for a second someone was attacking me.
Can I help you?
Yes, you can.
Hello.
I put up the posters.
Excellent. Not exactly usual Fighters Guild work, but critical if we're to grow our services. Unfortunately, the posters probably won't last long. Rough weather. Oh well. Here's your coin.
Should get them laminated.
Farewell.
Okay. Let's see. How else might we be of service? I'm gonna get away from the guard. With Gerald view in. Convince Cyrodiil not to press charges against Bentior. Back up here, I guess? It's the Gerald View Inn.
Damnable tavern! Damnable owner! How dare he allow that lizard to engage in such a salacious display? Scandalous!
I think I found him.
Can I help you?
Bentior, I want you to drop the charges. I guess this didn't work before. Excuse me.
Ha! Huh. That isn't going to happen, I'm afraid.
I guess...
Farewell.
Return to Bentior? Yep. Greetings.
Fresh meat in Bruma.
What's the snicker?
Hello.
What brings you to Bruma?
Skingrad didn't have as many lucrative opportunities as I would have liked. So I got thinking, how can I make my fortune? One of my friends, a Nord guy by the name of Nolir, he was insane for meat. Put a steak in front of his face and throw it all the way to Coral. He'd run after it like a rabid dog.
Okay, Coral.
He gave me the idea.
Coral!
I thought to myself, if the Nords love meat so much, why not cater directly to that need?
Okay.
Cut out the innkeeper, middleman, and let the Nords come to a dedicated butcher? And so I did exactly that.
Well, so how's business?
So-so. I mean, it's good, and I'm earning a decent living, but... I guess I expected more.
Hmm.
Here in Bruma, the most Nordic place in all Cyrodiil, I expected my meat to be selling by the bucket load. Nords and their appetite for meat and all. Seems what I didn't consider is that the Nords love meat just as much as they love fighting. They'll go out and strangle a deer to death, which you can probably guess undermines my business somewhat.
Okay.
Still, I'm doing all right. For a butcher.
There's not many Red Guards in Bruma.
You're right. There aren't. It doesn't surprise me. The biting chill up here is a far cry from the golden sun of Hammerfell. Far cry from the lukewarm of the rest of Cyrodiil, too, now that I think about it. Doesn't bother me as much as most. Then again, I spend most of my time in my house, with a nice warm hearth to keep me cozy.
Sling tells me that's Carlaya.
See you around.
Yep. She got bored. Now... the stuff has disappeared. Oh, that we can get rid of. Oh, that's both for Gort? Alright. So that didn't work. For, what? Yeah, that's not working there.
Hmm?
I said it's not working there.
Can I help you?
What is it?
Who's this guy? Aralus?
Why?
I don't remember. There's so many people here. So, back to the Restful Watchman then? They're by the cathedral, I believe. Here. Behind it. Maybe I can talk to this guy, Bentior. Oh, this guy in front.
Hello.
Hello. You're weird.
Hello?
What is it?
It's Bentior.
I've got rooms, I've got food and drinks, and 1,000 elven ladies under my belt.
Heard anything about stolen Akaviri heirlooms?
I don't tend to gossip about my patrons. Bad for business, you know. Especially when you're in my line of work.
Well, I bet gold will change your tune. There's 100 gold.
A little gold always greases the wheels. I'll tell you what you want to know.
Okay.
There's this Breton guy who comes through here every now and again.
Mm-hmm.
Sleaziest guy I've ever seen. Except for me, of course.
Oh, of course.
Got a reputation to maintain, you know? Name's Etienne. Or something like that. Anyway, he mentioned something to do with Akaviri trinkets while we spoke. Mentioned wanting to sell them or something. I guess he's your man.
Hmm. Where can I find this Etienne?
I don't know. Listen, do you really think I'm going to tell you everything about my customers? That's a sure way to get run out of this business.
Look at her looking at me. She's like, yeah, listen to him. Don't play dumb with me, Bentior. We're both smarter than that.
Listen. You want me to tell you so badly? Make me.
How?
I'm not budging until I've been forced to, legally. You know what I'm getting at, I assume.
Find a way to pressure Bentior into giving you more information.
You here to do business?
So swiping my sword at him?
Can I help you?
Place is filthy and seems to be full of undesirables.
Then go over to the Gerald View if it suits you better. Me, I think this inn has more character than Mr. Stantis Fancy Pants' little establishment.
How am I gonna find a way? Heard any rumors?
Alamu Nethre, Dark Elf girl. She's wanting adventurers to help her with something. Not sure what.
Yeah, talk to her.
Talk to you later.
Well, I don't know how to...
What can I do for you?
Have him persuade me.
What is it?
Can I talk to all these people?
Bye.
Until next time.
What was this guy, Harold? Can I say anything to him about these brochures?
Hello?
Nope.
Until next time.
Oh, he's the one that cowers and... They mistook you for someone.
This one calls you friend.
Oh, thanks. They're making fun of your name.
You're back. Any news on my wife? Who's the spineless wretch that sold us out? Tell me, now!
Oh, yeah. I think it was Simon Gautier.
Gautier? The Breton? I'll rip his... Wait, a Breton? Really? A Breton? Weak-willed, soft-spoken, magic-practicing bosses?
I beg your pardon.
How could a Breton overcome an orc, even with bandits on his side?
Magic.
I remember overhearing talk in the castle that Simon had a luxury manor up in the east of the Geralds somewhere.
He does.
Go search this guy's home. See if it actually was him.
Cool.
Find something, anything, that conclusively links him to the crime and bring it to me.
Sweet.
It is the damned Breton. That's when we act.
We march at dawn. Gather information from the nobles. Complete it. Okay, search Simmons.
Bretons. Now, they're like fresh-born Achatur. Pretty to look at, but not a use on Nern. Couldn't be him. Go, search his home. I want proof.
Better stop insulting.
The prey approaches.
Yeah, prey. Better stop.
Can I help you?
Insulting Bretons. Them's fighting words.
Can I help you?
Nope. Search Simmons' house for evidence. Okay. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know how to find a way to pressure him. Convince Renod. Is it Renod right around here? He's right around here, isn't he?
Gort's the name?
Yeah. Something like that. I'll turn that off because that didn't work.
Wins the game.
Actually, just kills the game. Tough. I guess you... Well, maybe you can walk through here? It is nighttime now. Wait. Let's just hang out. I gotta find Renod when his home isn't locked, when the guards arrest me. Hello there. Oh, I talked to her before. Hey, Renod.
You there? A traveler? In my house? Why, of course. You are here to sample the sweet sounds of Renod Haventone and his lute.
Nope.
Or his flute.
Nope. I'm here because your neighbors are complaining about a noise nuisance. Ready for it, guys?
Noise nuisance? Noise nuisance? What do you take me for, some Halloway wattrel? I'm a bard, you impudent fool!
Excuse
How
me?
How dare you speak to me in such a manner? And whoever complained? Such nerve!
They complained, not me.
Ah, yes. But you were the messenger girl, weren't you? You are the one who came to deliver their infernal message. Indeed, whoever it was that complained is likely an agent of Maroon's Dagon. For who else would have such distaste for the beauty of music?
Have you ever considered perhaps you're not as good as you think you are?
You insolent whelp! I am outraged! You barge into my home and then proceed to insult me!
Yeah, well.
I'm done with this conversation!
You are. Now see here.
Away with you, rube!
Is there anything I can do to convince you?
First you insult me, then you offer me aid. How unexpected. At least you're learning your place.
Always expect the unexpected.
Yes, I suppose there's something you can do. My prize lute is missing, and I'm forced to use this shoddy replacement. It is impacting my ability to perform greatly. Hmm. It is even making my renditions of Valenwood's Color Streams Anew into Sinew sound worse. Valenwood's Color Streams Anew into Sinew. That is a basic ballad. Absolutely basic. So, go and fetch my lute. Some thief took it, probably. Somewhere here in Bruma, I imagine. Off you go. Time's a-wasting.
I'll get your loot if you promise to stop being an annoyance to your neighbors. Now watch. Watch, I have a feeling this loot is like some kind of magic loot that when he uses it, he's frickin' amazing. That would be really cool. And he can't tell when it's, you know, he's frickin' amazing or not. Yeah, I'll get it if you promise to stop being an annoyance to your neighbors.
Annoying! I will try to hold my rage for now, but not try my patience, Rube. Go fetch the loot before I clunk you over the head with my flute!
Hey! Turd.
Oh, look! A pumpkin!
You're pretty good with the insults here, too. Well, not good with them, but just, you like using them. Do you have any idea who stole the loot?
Nope. None at all. Try asking the ruffians over at the Restful Watchman. That's where most of the riffraff like to drink themselves into a stupor. Come to speak to the best bard in all Tamriel? Unsurprising. Go on then, speak.
What can you tell me about the Restful Watchman?
They call it a tavern, but I'd call it more of a bunkhouse for the homeless and destitute. It's where the lazy, idle, and untalented go to live their shallow, miserable lives. They drink themselves stupid, vomit everywhere, and then collapse into their frayed jute cloth beds. At least they feed the lice. Disgusting place.
They feed the lice.
Unfit for one such as myself. So you won't find me renting a room there. That I can guarantee.
Hmm. I wonder if there's anything there I can use. Again, probably not, but...
Hello.
You follow me over there? You're supposed to be in front of the Restful Watchman. Which is over here. Yeah, I was saying, I wonder if there's anything I can use against, what's his name to tell me about? Nope. Alright. His name rhymes with anus. Is there anything that he could have told me that would help me convince this guy to tell me about the heirlooms? Who stole the heirlooms?
Rizzada the Resplendent, Enchanter Extraordinaire, Illusionist Incredible, Restorer Remarkable, and Destructor Established.
Your reckless disregard for the law has come to an end. You're under arrest.
Follow me in here. I don't have time for this, do you?
A small-time criminal? Not what I want on my service record. Go turn yourself into some other guard. Mm-hmm. Not stooping to your level.
I don't suppose that's
by the Synod, weary of the whispers,
Why not go somewhere more agreeable?
Can I help you?
Do you know anything about Renod Eventone's lute?
Even if I did, why would I tell you anything? So you could go like the good little saint you are and tell the guards? No.
It's to make him shut up.
Oh, really? Well, in that case, I suppose I can make an exception. We kicked that old horker out of here a little while back. Can still hear him from his house across the way. It'd be nice to get rid of that nuisance. Here's the truth. Yes, I took it. Hmm. It was made out of a fine oak and encrusted with some rubies. Good gold, friend.
You sold it?
So I sold it to some of my most prolific business partners.
Who are they? Who are these business partners?
Capstone Cave. Hmm. It's not too far from Bruma. By all means, go take it up with them. Either they'll kill you or you'll kill them. Makes no difference to me. Our business has already concluded. However, I have a smarter proposal.
Oh, do you? What do you suggest?
We drove Renod out of the Watchman, and he's no doubt had the same happen at the Gerald View. He's out of work.
Hmm.
I'm sure you've seen the hilarious Bardic Masterclass posters he's putting up all around Bruma in the hope of keeping a roof over his head. Well, tell him he's got a new venue to play at. Tell him to go to Capstone and play. Those boys have been looking for some entertainment for a while now. You'll have to negotiate it with them at the cave first, of course. If you do that, either they keep him and Renod is successfully out of Bruma, or they punish him. And no one's any the wiser.
I have to talk to these people first. I don't want them to hurt him. I mean, that would be kind of extreme. So yeah, I'm going to Capstone Key, but I haven't said why.
As you should. Which option you decide to pursue is your concern. Negotiate him a job or retrieve the loot by force. Doesn't matter much to me. Just don't drag me into this again. My only interest in Renod is hearing him shut up. This is not my affair.
Bretons.
Is this your affair?
Like freshborn Ashotter. Pretty to look at, but not a use
this
on
this one called you friend.
It couldn't be him. Go.
Look.
Sir.
Hmm?
Shut up about Bretons.
Hey, old friend.
You here to do business? I've got rooms, I've got food, and drinks, and 1,000 elven ladies under my belt.
I wonder if there's anything upstairs that I could use against him. Probably not. Oh, I'll get stuck in here, won't I? Oh, I'm lucky. Good timing.
Good afternoon.
Rosada's not saying anything for once. Okay, I think we're actually done then in... Alright, we gotta find the loot, which is elsewhere. Search Simmons' house, that's elsewhere. This wasn't working. Pressure Bentior. That's Frozen Grotto, elsewhere. Pale Pass. Underpaul Cave. This stuff is not part of the mod. This doesn't work because he keeps wanting to arrest me. Kill the bandit ringleader of Capstone Cave. Huh? That's a second one at Capstone Cave. Interesting. Book of Killing. We're gonna find another home for this dog.
What is it?
Greetings.
Now yeah, let's start talking.
Ancient Nordic ornaments, weapons, armor, you name it, I have it.
Gain your energy. Potions for sale here.
Silverpaw? Thank you, Silverpaw?
Yes, dearie.
Talk to her.
The cold nips up here in the mountains, but I've always loved how refreshing it is.
Are you talking about cold nips?
Yes, traveler. What do you need?
Everything you see here is for sale. Well, except the actual stall. I kind of need that.
How's business?
All right, I suppose. My sales pitch isn't very good, I know, but I still get a fair few customers. Everyone needs something to wear, I guess.
Hmm. You seem nervous.
You can tell, huh? Yeah, I'm not exactly the best salesman. Don't exactly like being one either. Don't worry, though, I'm a much better tailor than I am a merchant.
So why are you a merchant if you don't like being one? I guess you've got to make some coin where you can, right?
You know, I always thought about doing something else. Becoming an adventurer or whatnot.
Hmm.
It's just, well, I'm not cut out for that kind of lifestyle. As my good ma always said, Gryfard, my worthless, good-for-nothing son, you gotta do something with your life.
Nice mother.
And since you seem to be better at sewing than spellcasting, you best become a clothing merchant, so here I am. Yeah, she's a lovely woman, my mother. Powerful mage, too. If you see her around these parts, though, you warn me right away. She's the reason I left High Rock.
It's getting better and better.
If I don't have it, you don't need it.
Alright. Just a bunch of clothing, of course. It's just what he sells. Oh, I like that one. But I'm close to being overweight, aren't I? That's actually pretty. I'll have to remember to come back for him. To him.
Talk to you later.
Talking to you later.
For clothing sale. I mean, clothing for sale.
Hello there.
For clothing sale.
Damnable tavern. Damnable owner. How dare you?
What is it?
It's a dingy squat. I want its proprietor to land in hot water with our dear guard captain. He deserves it, no? Say, would you help me with that?
Yeah, I'll do it.
Excellent. As it so happens, I'm a mage by trade. I have access to many magical items from my home of Alanor. Take this. It's a very special memory gem. I have one active at all times, and this particular one recorded everything that happened in the tavern that night.
Hmm.
Take it, and let the guard captain listen to it. Irrefutable evidence.
If I can talk to
I'm
me.
I'm sure he'll see fit to take action then.
Farewell. Can I help you?
Okay, so what if instead I return to this guy? Oh, I hate these guys. That's a dead end.
Oh,
don't
look,
talk.
An infant.
Don't.
How quaint.
Talk. No words.